Kathak is a natural dance form. We do not use much stylized gestures or movements. Whatever we do in our daily life, we can express it through Kathak. Like if you are going to show a flower, this can be a flower. It is very natural movement, anyone can make. Anyone. Can you please show it like this with your hands? This one. Yes, exactly. This is a flower. You can show it with this. It's a flower. Picking a flower. How do you pick a flower? Yes, exactly. This kind of mudra we use. This picking up. So in any other classical dance forms, we do not use this kind of gestures. Only in Kathak, we use natural gestures. These are the small glimpses you just saw. Indian classical dances are the dances of mind and soul and are extremely traditional. It is deeply rooted with Hinduism. Hinduism is the religion where mostly all Indians belong to. It is believed from a Hindu point of view that the whole universe is being brought into existence and is the manifestation of the dance of supreme dancer Nataraja or Shiva. It is also to be said gods and goddesses pleaded with Lord Brahma for another religious book to be created that would be simple for common man to understand in modern age. You can see the image of Nataraja. This is the image of Lord Shiva. It is said that he is the king of dance. Let drama and dance be the fifth Vedic scripture, combined with an epic story tending to virtue, wealth, joy and spiritual freedom. It must contain the significance of every scripture and forward every art. Thus, from all the Vedas, Brahma framed the Natya Veda. From the Rig Veda, he drew forth the words from Sama Veda, the melody. From the Yajur Veda, gestures. From the Atharva Veda, the sentiment. Indian dance has some salient features, some aspects. This Natya Veda or Natya Shastra is the most ancient and the most elaborate scripture describing every element and aspect of dance worship. According to Natya Shastra, all classical Indian dances comprises three aspects. Nritya, which you can see the first thing you saw in the video, the very technical part, that is called Nritya, that is rhythmic element. It does not have any emotion. You can see different kinds of rhythm, and only way you can feel the joy. And second is Natya, that is drama, dramatic element, expression, sentiments. You can put your ideas into this through Natya. Thirdly is Nritya. It is a combination of Nritya and Natya. Natya is expression and Nritya is rhythm. So three things are can be seen in dance. A very important feature of Indian classical dances is the use of mudras or hand gestures. Just now I told you that if you want to pick a flower, how will you pick? Everyone said this like this. And the flower you can show in this way. So there are many mudras or hand gestures which can tell you a story, a full-fledged story. You can tell it with this. There you can see in first picture, that is mushti. In Indian dance forms, mushti is something which can show you, like something you, if you're holding something, strength, power. If you are someone who is very strong. Secondly is peacock. Peacock we show with this. Thirdly, half moon, Ardha Chandra. So you need to know this code, this gesture, this code. Ardha Chandra is half moon. Fourth is Caesar. Caesar. Fifth is peak of the mountain, Shikhar. Peak of the mountain, Shikhar. Sixth is flag. So this kind of gestures with this flag, we can show air. If we slap someone like this, if we cut something like this, so this kind of gestures are very helpful to tell you the whole story. Budding lotus. So these kind of hand gestures are very helpful to tell you the story. Kathak itself is saying that storytelling. So these are very helpful mudras or gestures, can tell you the whole story. There are other dance forms. Bharatanatyam, Kuchipudi, Kathak, Satre dance, Manipuri, Kathakali, Mohiniyattam, Odissi dance. Bharatanatyam dance is classical dance form originating in Tamil Nadu, a state in South India, and is known as the Indian national dance. It resembles the old way of worship dance form performed by temple devadasis in ancient times. Many of the ancient sculptures in Hindu temples are based on Bharatanatyam dance postures. There are other dance forms also. These all dance forms are very different from each other, very, very different. Kuchipudi dance is a classical dance form from India, Andhra Pradesh, combines fast rhythms with fluid movements, creating a nice blend of control and abandon, strength and delicacy. Specifically, there is Tarangam of Kuchipudi, which is unique in that the dancer must dance upon a brass plate. Placing the feet upon the raised edges. The dancer moves the plate with much balance, as the individual is traditionally dancing on the plate with two diyas, small oil burning candles in his or her hands while balancing. Kathak dance. This dance form traces its origin to the nomadic birds of ancient northern India. These birds performing in village, squares, temples, mostly specialized in recounting or mythological stories or tales. They used to embellish these tales with beautiful gestures, hand gestures, and facial expression. Satriya dance is one of the eight principal classical dance forms from Assam. Satriya has remained a living tradition since its creation by the founder of Vaishnavism in Assam, the great saint Srimanta Shankardev in 15th century Assam. Manipuri dance is purely religious and its aim is spiritual experience. Development of music and dance has through religious festivals and daily activities of the Manipuri people. Kathakali dance is highly stylized. As I told you that in Kathak, as it is a natural dance form, if you say a flower, you show like this. In Kathakali, it should be like this. It is much stylized, very, very prominent. And in Kathak, it is very natural, like this. In Kathak, if you stand as I'm standing, it is very natural posture. But in other classical dance form, you have to be very stylized, like this, always. Mohiniyattam dance is the feminine dance form of Kerala. It is danced by women and is known for its very sexual themes. The word Mohiniyattam literally means dance of enchantress. There is a typical costume for Mohiniyattam. It is generally simple, white or off-white, usually gold brocade, possibly with a border of red, as you can see there. Odissi dance. It originates from the state of Odisha. It is particularly distinguished from the other classical dance form by the importance it places upon the Trimangi, literally three parts, breaks, independent movement of head, chest, pelvis, upon the basic square stance known as Chopra. Now I would like to show you the basic posture of each dance form. In Bharatanatyam, usually like this. Kuchipudi is also in this way. In Odissi, it is like this. Usually. This is called Trivangi. It has a three part, you can see. Kathak is very straight, very straight. Manipuri usually circle. So each dance form has a geometric form. Kathak, straight. Manipuri, circle. Kathakali, square. Odissi, triangle. So this kind of geometric things you can see. Devdasi dance tradition. The Devdasi was called Nitya Sumangali, the evergreen bride. The consort of the immortal, she therefore never could be tainted by widowhood compared to the women of her day. The highly educated Devdasi enjoyed riches, power, and an elevated status, unconstrained by the duties of married life. In addition to taking care of temple and performing rituals, this woman learned and practiced other classical Indian artistic tradition and enjoyed a high social status, as dance and music were essential part of temple worship. There is ancient era of mythological stories. During this ancient era, to live in mythological stories, the priests would recite and emote out and accompany them with hand gestures and facial expressions. This form of storytelling was adopted by storytellers in temples, which used to be prime entertainment for people to visit the temple to listen stories of great kings, warriors, gods, goddesses, and divine love stories. Storytelling was adopted by storytellers in temples, streets, various gatherings, and evolved into an early version of dance form that was passed on from generation to generation. A lot of stories were narrated from great epics of Ramayana, Mahabharata, among many stories, most famous being the story told by two princes, Lav and Kush. It was said that when Ram came back to Lav Kush, Lav Kush performed Katha dance to tell Rama about their mother Sita. Then gradually it comes 13th to 15th century, that era of worship, Bhakti movement. During the medieval age brought new influences of devotion and love stories. Dance were performed of Radha, Krishna and Hindu gods. They were incorporated into the dance form. Bhakti style of music by saints, teachers of that era also contributed to the formation styles of classical dances. Storytellers used to perform the poetries, spiritual poets like Mirabai, Surdas, Kavitas, Tulsidas, all the dances, music and the poetry were inspired by Lord Krishna. Then it comes 16th century. In the Mughal era, Kathak dance was most affected. It experienced a metamorphism and was brought to the courts of Mughal kings. The Persian influences were added, intricate footwork, spectacular spins, and exquisite expression that are major characteristics of dance form as we know it today. The music and musical instruments used to accompany the dancers were also influenced by the Persian music and culture. Intricate footwork, I'd like to show you. Well, we use ghumru, but now I'm not wearing ghumru. Ghumru is a bell. We wear 100 bells on each leg. I can show it. This is the ghumru we wear, and it has 100 bells. It's quite heavy, and it sounds. And you can see when we dance, that each rhythm, each movement, it is. If I wear it, so it understands. So before, the dancers used to perform Kathak. Just there to say, a girl is going to fetch water in an earthen pot and she is looking for someone she loves. So used facial expression, costumes, So this is the way. In Mughal era, what happens? The dancers were imported from Persia, in the Middle East, and they added straight-legged footwork, hand gestures, those are less stylized, and spins. I don't know whether I can take spins here, but I'll try.
So footwork like
I already told about the less stylized mudra, hand gestures, spins, and footwork. Now, the essence of Kathak. The word Katha means story, and Kathak means storyteller. Storytelling while singing, emoting, and dancing all together with stylized gestures. Kathak is characterized by intricate footwork and precise rhythmic patterns. And the dancer articulates by controlling about 150 ankles, sometimes 100. So, rhythmic footwork. It takes its movements from life. Like, if you're showing, I'm going somewhere in Kathak, how will you show?
Baby.
So these are all the things, all the gestures you can use in when you hold your baby. You hold like this only, right? So this can be thing. This expression can be used Muslim dance. The Gumru, you have seen already Gumru. Tabla, sarod. Sitar, pagavaj, harmonium. These are the instruments we use in Kathak performance. Vocal music we use invocation, offerings to God, teachers, and Thumri, love poem of Lord Krishna, Radha, Ram, Sita. Bhajan, Kajri, Chaipai. Recitation of syllables, Bol, Parand. In Kathak, always we perform when with syllables. We utter some syllables like Tante, 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 Aante, 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 Tante, 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 Tante. So, this kind of syllables we use, but it doesn't have any meaning actually. But it gives you the rhythm. I'd like to show how I can dance with this rhythm. So with the rhythm we dance. We say something and then we dance. These are the costumes we wear. I'm wearing anarkali. This is a very traditional costume for Kathak dance. It has different kinds of designs because we have three schools of dancing. I belong to Lakhno Gharana, which is more soft and incorporated with facial expression. There are Banaras and Jaipur Gharana. In this Gharana, they use more strong footwork, facial expression is less, acting part is less. These are the Kathak attire for men. This is called Bandi, the white one he is wearing. Well, Kathak is a collaborative form of performing art that uses live performers to present the experience of a real and imagined event before a live audience in a specific place. We use dance, song, different kinds of percussion, instruments, everything we use. Stage crafts are used to enhance the physicality, presence and immediacy of the experience. Strings and Steps is my organization and it is a cultural group. It is one and only musical group in the world which is an exclusive venture presenting Kathak dance and Hawaiian guitar simultaneously. on the same speed, complementing each other. This is an amalgamation of Hindustani classical dance, supplemented by the Western instrument playing Hindustani danka.
Okay. cái đó cái cách cái đó cái nó chạy cha cái đi cái cha không có đi cái đó cái ai ta cái cái đó cái 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 cái
God. Krishna is said that he is
the god of our dance forms, Krishna. Krishna, all the dance, all Kathak dance depicts the story of little Krishna, about his life, about his love life, about his mother and the relationship with him. Here is Lord Ganesha. Ganesha is very, you can see, very sweet looking god, which is having a head of elephant. It was said that Ganesha's mother was taking shower, and she said Ganesha that you should see that no one should visit as I'm taking bath. So he was on the door, and at that time his father came. Well, let me tell you one thing, that Ganesha, when he was born, Lord Shiva did not know that he has got a son. How he was there? Because he was born with the strength and power of his mother, Ma Durga. So Ma Durga has got this son with his strength and power, and his father, Lord Shiva, did not know this. So when he came, when he tried to enter his house, Lord Shiva, when goddess Durga was taking shower, he just restrained. He told that you cannot yet enter because my mother is taking shower. And that time Lord Shiva cut his head. He was saying that this is my house, my wife is there, who are you to tell me that not to go inside? So he came on his rage and cut his head. That time the goddess Durga came out and said, what you have done to my son? He is your son too, because you have cut his head, you should make him alive again. I don't know how you will do that, but you have to make him alive. So Lord Shiva went and got an elephant and cut his head, and he just joined his head with his elephant head. Now Lord Shiva's and goddess Durga's, the most favorite child, he is always with his mother and father, his parents. So there are many things, their love relationship, their strength, their power, and of course the wrong thing who has done by this Lord Shiva, how he repents, everything we can find in this Hinduism, in these stories of as I told you, Lord Shiva as Ardhanarishvara, that universe is working, it is going with strength, power and softness, the grace. So here is a picture of half Shiva and half Parvati. You can see half Shiva is man, half Parvati is woman. The union of this principle is exalted as the root and the proof of all creation. This is Nakti Shastra. Nakti Shastra remained an important text in the fine arts of many centuries, so much so that it is sometimes referred as the fifth Veda. Verse from Nakshastra. Yato hasta sato drishti. Where the hand goes, there the eyes should follow. So all the dancers should remember that if anyone is dancing here, you should follow your eyes where your hand goes. Like in our dance, in our Kathak dance, everything starts from here. In Kathak dance, each and every movement, a single movement has a story, has a meaning. Okay, the first movement, the very basic movement, I want to show that the flower of respect we offer to God, and God gives us blessings. So this thing, how will you show?
The flower of respect from the core of our heart, from here, we offer to God, and God gives our blessings. And we keep it forever. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So this is a very basic movement. This way. The second movement,
second very basic movement, is just like you are in the garden standing and you fetch some flower from the garden and you offer to the God.
One, two, amidst the garden. Three, you got the flower. Three, and offer to the God. Flower, we get. Got the flower. Offer to the God.
Third movement, we are welcoming our guest. We welcome, how we welcome our guest? Can you tell me? Just come, you. As I say, please do come. I'm home. I'm just coming. I'm getting something for you. Nice. So, this is like one. Come. Two. Please have a seat. I'm just coming with something for you. Please come. Have a seat. I'm coming something for you. Wait. So here it is saying, Yato hastam sato drishti. Where the hand goes, there the eyes should follow. Yato drishti sato manata. Where the eyes are, there our mind should follow. Where your hand goes, if you look there, and if you look there, your mind is there. Where the mind is there, the expression should be brought out. If you are looking there, whatever I am looking, you can see in my mind, which is very beautiful. If something bad is there, I should my expression should be like this, or something good. It's like that. Something which I'm feeling shy. I should be like this.
So, whatever the movement and my gesture, everything is depicted by the expression and our hand gestures and facial expression. Where the expression is, there are the flavor will be experienced. You don't know that what I'm thinking now, okay? But I can make you think what I'm thinking. Like, Lord Krishna, do you know who was Lord Krishna? Lord Krishna is a god, okay? He is there and I'm looking at him and I'm in love with him. Fine? Lord Krishna, here I am with my bell. I'm looking at him and I'm in love with him. So this is the way we express our dance through expression, mudra, and our body movements. That's it. Thank you so much.